Na 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 na. Yeah. Na 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 na.
Grading built like this. You belong to him. He belong to me. He's a villain. You're a baby. And boy, Daryl. Mr. Daryl. Oh, wait a minute. Mr. Daryl. And we're going to do a good one here because every year, this time, before Christmas, Mr. Daryl is here. And he, you know why I love the guy? Because he calls me Papa. Everybody calls me Papa. Mr. Daryl comes here. Oh, I thought he was in Delaware. I always forget. I'm a nincompoop. I forget. Maryland, Delaware, it's all the same. You gotta go either Route 40 or Route 95. And then, all the way from Washington, D.C., he comes down, says hello, walks in, takes pictures. Everybody knows him. And, Johnny, I'll see you later. I'll be back. Good, man. Rain or shine. Now, the funny thing is, today he's here and I'm angry. You know why I'm angry? Because he chose you, Kid Rico, to be his boy because he wanted to hang over with my boy, PJ Nelly. And you know, he's a villain. And you know, he's my boy, and you know, I'm a villain, right? Now, you guys are supposed to be good guys. But then Mr. Daryl said that he could guarantee that you could drop kick, do all kinds of dancing on his head, and you're gonna be the champion. I don't know why, because he's got the belt. And remember, he's got the belt. I want to know what Mr. Daryl, and if you could take that camera that he's showing at me, and I'm looking at you, Mr. Pete Rico, I'm gonna tell you one thing now. I could hold that camera on my pal over here, PJ Nelly is his name, in case you guys don't know. He said that the next show here, February 3rd, he said that you're going to take the title from him. Now, what's the title called, Bobby?
Heavyweight title.
The heavyweight title you have? How do you wind up with that heavyweight? Oh my God, he knows more than me. I mean, you hear that, Mr. Darren? Now you, Rico, who was champion before, tag team, junior, and all that good stuff, you're looking for the heavyweight. Wait a minute, you're not heavy enough to be in the heavyweight. That thing is going to fall on of your butt. But Mr. Daryl over here, and I call him Mr. Daryl because I can't call him nothing, but he got to be big now. I mean, this gentleman's been around with the wrestling business, I don't know how long. But you know, now he comes to New York, so he figured he could walk in my office and tell him, I'm going to help Rico. Keep Rico, get the belt away from them because it's about time. Well, you want to hold his camera, and he could tell me something. But before I give him the mic, it's called a mic. I'm not even looking at him because I don't want to even laugh at him. Let me explain something. It's called a mic. Mr. Mike to Mr. Daryl. Before I give him that, I'm going to tell him. If you guys could take the belt away from my boy PJ Nelly, I might go in the ring and give you both a beating, and I'm gonna hit you so hard, both of you, that the pictures in your wallet are gonna cry. Now, take that to the bank. Now, you wanna say something? Yeah, did you? Yeah, he's your boy. What do you want to say? Oh, wait a minute. Should I give him the mic?
Mr.
Well, who's going to hold the camera?
I will.
You want to? Yeah. Mr. Daryl, I don't know what you want to say, but you can say, I don't know what you call your show because I know what you call it, but I ain't putting you over. I want you to put your show over and tell what are you going to do with him. You're going to manage him to do my boy, PJ Nelly? Well, remember what I said. If you guys can't prove that, I'm going to join him, tag team, I'm going to go to the ring and give you guys a beating. I tell you, every little picture you got in your wallet is going to have tears. Here's the mic. You better take that camera because I ain't saying nothing else. Don't look at me, Mr. Darryl. You better come over here and show him over there. Let's do it.
The story goes like this. Dr. D back in the NYC. PJ Melly. You got the crown right now, but there's a new king in town. It's my boy, Kid Rico. He's gonna come to take the sword of Arthur and attack Johnny's Merlin, if you get what I'm saying. Because one thing's for sure, kings don't always last forever, but gods do. And Kid Rico is a god right now. So come February the 3rd, here in Brooklyn, NYC, Kid Rico is ready to show you, EJ Melly, why he is the god of WUW. End of story.
Now, did you see how I create rage?
I want to see it.
Now you're going to see it. And he's going to use it because he's starting to get. But here's what happens. When he ended it, that's his thing. I knew him how he used it. Because I trust him. He can use it any way I want. And this thing here that happened. But I'm trying to build you up. How you rating? If they can do this and put it on TV and then come back months later with this program, people are going to get, oh, I wonder what happened with Johnny and Mr. Darrow. Because I know Mr. Darrow has the radio program. He's been around for years. But that, yeah. Johnny, that man doesn't wrestle. Why is Johnny picking on the guy? You follow me? Because we're villains, you see. We're baby faces. But I already said what I was going to do with you. And I talk a lot of big stuff of old men like me, talking all that good stuff with young Mr. Darrow. See, I build a ring and everyone's like, what shit for real, Johnny's mad at Mr. Darrow? You don't count. Him count. Because everybody knows this business. And well, why is he picking on the whole guy? Making sound of him off, see? That's raging.
The story goes like this. Dr. D's Wrestling Showcase is on the air. I'm back here in Gleason's Gym, Brooklyn, New York, and I'm here with my world's unpredictable wrestling family. So shout out to my papa, WWE Hall of Famer, the unpredictable Johnny Rod. And I'm here with the WUW Light Heavyweight Champion, Prince Ahmed. Ahmed, how are you feeling this evening?
I'm feeling great. I'm the first Egyptian Light Heavyweight Champion, so I'm pretty happy about that.
Very good, very good. So, congratulations to you on becoming a champ. You defeated a veteran in the form of WWE's own Matt Stryker, also Lucha Underground. But tell us, man, you know, how does it feel to beat established veteran such as Matt Stryker?
I'm honored, honestly, because I've been only here for a year now, and just in 1 year, I couldn't imagine that I would win the belt and pin Matt Stryker, so it's a huge honor to me. Not just that, it was like three other guys in there, like I really look up to them, so me walking out of the gym, I'm really, really grateful.
How long you been in the business so far?
A year and 2 months.
Oh wow, so you're practically a rookie, and you're definitely learning very fast, especially for somebody like the unpredictable Johnny Rod. Now, February the 3rd, back here at Gleason's Gym, WUW has a card that's coming up. First card of 2018. Tell us how you're going to prepare for who your opponent may be.
I really don't care who my opponent is because I really know how good I am and how I can beat them. As other guys, they wrestle like the Lucha way, they wrestle the American way, the Japanese way. I wrestle my own way. That's the Egyptian way. And until now, it's working pretty good.
You know, it's pretty interesting because there's not really a lot of wrestling that you hear about coming from the land of Egypt. And the thing is, you being here in New York City, it should be a different aspect to see how wrestling in Egypt is and how their style is. So how would you describe the Egyptian style of wrestling?
My style is like, I would do whatever it takes just to win. And like, I know, like, do a lot of submissions so I can torture people. So that's kind of the most of the Egyptian way. You have to really watch it to figure it out. You will know that's really different. It's a really different style.
Well, as the almanac, I definitely have to do my research and look up some Egyptian styles of wrestling. But I'm very glad to be talking with the light heavyweight champion, Prince Ahmed. See you soon, February 3rd. End of story. All right, we're back, Dr. D's Wrestling Showcase, back at Gleason's Gym, February 3rd, Brooklyn, New York. WUW is coming back here to put on a fantastic show, the very first show of 2018. And I'm here with the former WUW Light Heavyweight Champion, Kid Rico. It's been a long time since I've seen my man. Rico, how you feeling now that you don't have the strap on you, brother?
You know, I'm a little upset because I had the privilege of holding pretty much all the titles here.
Yeah.
And actually, I haven't been Light Heavyweight Champ yet, but this close.
Okay.
This close, but Prince of Man, I'll beat you in the last show, so I'm hoping to get another shot.
Let me tell you something right now. You held just about every title you said in WUW, so you can pretty much go after any belt, but right now your eyes are on the Light Heavyweight title. Why is it very important for you to face Prince Ahmed in this possible rematch?
You know, because Prince Ahmed had unfortunate help. He had Matt Stryker in the ring, and he had Mantis and Jacob. If those guys weren't in the ring, he wouldn't have had all that time to put all that, you know, pain and pain down on me. But I am confident that with my 4 years ability in the WWE, that Prince Ahmed doesn't even have the talent to come anywhere near what I have. And I can outperform, I'll strike him, I'll wrestle him, I'll submission him. He talks about how his way is the Egyptian way, but I wrestle the Johnny way. And if he thinks that he can compete with me, he has another thing coming down.
Ladies and gentlemen, Prince Ahmed is looking for another championship. This could be one of the first Grand Slam champions in WUW history. So Brooklyn, Gleason's Gym, February the 3rd, we'll be seeing you soon as WUW makes his return in 2018. End of story.
Yeah. Yeah. Let's go. Nah, nah.